गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन यस्टरडे क्लास वी स्टडी अबाउट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन, द ड्यूअल नेचर, पार्टिकल एज वेल एज वेव नेचर. टुडे वी स्टडी ए न्यू पैरामीटर दैट इज क्वांटाइज्ड एटॉमिक स्पेक्ट्रा, बोहर मॉडल फॉर हाइड्रोजन एटम एंड इट्स लिमिटेशन. स्टूडेंट्स, एट फर्स्ट वी स्टडी व्हाट इज स्पेक्ट्रम. इन 10th क्लास वी नो when white light pass through the prism, then it change into 7 colors. A white light split into 7 colors known as spectrum. Students, we know in this electromagnetic radiation, this one is a large range of electromagnetic radiation, and this a very small area, this one visible region. In this visible region we can see, if we slightly enlarge only this visible region, we already discussed, but again we want to discuss violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red color. And the wavelength of this region is 400 nanometer to 750 nanometer. Wavelength increase in this side and frequency increase this side. Frequency that is 7.5 into 10 to the power 14 hertz to 4 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. Students, this white light is split up into 7 different colors: red, yellow, green, and then last that is violet and blue. This area blue and green. So this one is spectrum. When this white light split up into 7 different colors, in this way rainbow formation, we know rainbow formation after a rain. When the air droplets, the water droplets remaining in our atmosphere, that act as a prism. When the white light pass through that prism, then at evening on western side we get this rainbow, like this rainbow formation, that is red color, and we get violet color. This type of color we get on that rainbow, and in this some green color also there. So students, this like rainbow we can observe when the light pass through the droplets of water in our atmosphere, and at evening we get this type continuous. So this one is a continuous spectrum. It means the violet color merge in indigo, indigo merge in blue, blue merge in green, and green merge in yellow, and then orange. So orange and then red color. So they one color merge to other color. So that spectrum is continuous spectrum. Continuous spectrum. When white light pass through prism, then it change into 7 colors, and these 7 colors merge to each other, that are continuous spectrum. Students, but this is not actually, we can't find this type spectrum. There are further, there is a gap also. So now we study different spectrum, absorption and emission spectrum. And such type spectrum study a branch of science known as spectroscopy. Spectroscopy. On that spectroscopy we study absorption and emission spectrum. So how can absorption and emission spectrum occurs, and the which color is more deviated and which is least? We know, students, violet color deviation is most. Why? Its wavelength is lowest. This question comes in 10th class, which color is most deviated and which is least. that is violet color deviates most and red color is least because it's more wavelength, this is lower wavelength. So that are the reason. So red color appears from a long distance and at the sunset and sunrise, the sun color appears reddish color. The reason behind this, that time wavelength increase and the only red color wavelength reach to our earth surface. In morning and evening, when sunset and sunrise, we have the sun color appears reddish color. That are the reason. And our atmosphere act as a prism. So now we explain absorption and emission spectrum. Students, our next topic is spectrum. Spectrums are two types. One is absorption spectrum and other one is emission spectrum. How can absorption and emission spectrum? Students, when we supply heat or energy, then what happen? Atom, molecule or ion move into excited state. That energy absorbed. That time spectrum is absorption spectrum. For example, this one is an atom or a molecule. The atom electrons are in excited state. When these electrons pass through a slit and through a prism, and then prism, this white light split up into different 7 colors. Students, you can see the prism in our physics lab. You have already seen in 10th class, like this one is a prism. So this prism, when we pass the white light, it is split up into 7 colors. Actually, this is not continuous colors because energy neither absorb or release out at continuous. It's released at small packet at discrete units. Already discussed by Max Planck that energy release as small packet in quantum. So in similar way, we get such type, that time energy release out, that this one is emission spectrum. Emission spectrum. The atom, molecule, ion in excited state, so that come to lower ground state. When come the electron on ground state, that time energy release, and that time spectrum is emission spectrum. Actually, this energy not release continuous, so this one is a line spectrum. And it opposite, that is a source of sample, and the light pass on this absorbing material. This one material absorb energy, and then through pass the prism. So this again, that is split up into 7 colors, but this time spectrum is absorption spectrum. Absorption spectrum. Absorption and emission both are like black and white photography. Students, you have seen in earlier time, that is black and white photography. You can see any reel in your home. In that reel, our that head, that hair are find white color and other body part found in black color. That is face and all these things. And when we make that photo, then it change into reverse. Means the black are black and face into white color. That is like black and white photography. Similar way, absorption and emission also opposite. Where there is dark lines, they found at white lines, and that given in your NCERT book, different colors means that if this is white, then it's black, and this dark, then this white lights. Given in your NCERT book at page 41. You can see that emission and absorption both are like black and white photography opposite to each other. And this spectrum is not continuous. This is actually line spectrum. This line spectrum, a scientist observed, that is Robert Bunsen. Robert Bunsen discovered some elements like these, our fingerprints. Students, you know, we have a person have a characteristic fingerprint, thumb impression. In similar way, these elements have a characteristics, these are line spectrum. Due to that line spectrum, they find cesium, gallium, thallium, scandium, These type element they can find by the line spectrum, cesium, gallium, thallium, scandium, indium. So these element find by the Robert Bunsen by these characteristics. And a noble gas, that is helium. Helium also discovered by these characteristics, line spectrum. So they are characteristics for any element. You can see any that object if you purchase from any multiplex, and then what happen on that hole, there is found some lines and there is barcode reader, and they read the characteristics of that items and easily cut the rupees, and that is characteristics for that substance. In similar way, these are spectrum and easily identify such elements. Now our detailed discussion in that you will study in higher classes about the spectrum. Now students, we study hydrogen spectrum. Hydrogens, we know a molecule. Hydrogen have covalent bonding, the two hydrogen atom having a single bond. When energy supplied, so this hydrogen molecule are dissociate, they convert into hydrogen atom, and this atom when further energy supplied, that change into excited state. When further energy supplied, then it change into excited state. So that time spectrum, a scientist Balmer, a scientist, L is silent in this. Balmer observed in 1885, discussed the hydrogen spectrum. So he gave a formula, that is according to that spectrum. What happened? He got a line spectrum like this, one line, then like this, these are lines, these are N1, N2, N3, N4, like these lines. So the scientist observed when the electron jump from higher to second cell, this cell, from higher to this cell, these are the lines, like one, N5, N6, in the similar way, this N infinity. So students, Balmer observed when the electron jumps, the electron come on this second line only, these lines. So these are Balmer lines, Balmer series, Balmer lines, yes, series. And this observed in visible region. You know that visible region is a very short range. So this observed in visible region. And these lines are different colors. They observed different color, like they observed different colors. In visible region, we know different colors line. We get different colored line, like this. So students, the Balmer give a formula that depend on wave number. He gave a direct formula, Balmer, that given a constant 109,677, a value that is a Rydberg constant, then 1/2² minus 1/N². This formula given by the Balmer, that is equal to centimeter inverse. So 109,677, this one is a constant, that known as Rydberg constant. Rydberg, a Swedish scientist, Swedish spectroscopist, Rydberg constant. Rydberg constant is 109,677. 677 centimeter inverse. This one is a Rydberg constant. And the 2 means second line. When electron come from higher to only second line, so this is 2. And what are this n? N value more than 2. This n value more than 2 means that n value may be 3, 4, 5, 6 or so on. So this n value more than 2 from the higher cell. So these lines are Balmer series, and the scientist find out wave number by this formula. That is he find the exact formula by this we can find, and this one is a constant. According to that scientist, easily can find out, and this color only observed in visible region. So this one are hydrogen spectrum, and detail we study in Bohr model. So students, so actual hydrogen spectrum discussed in 1885 by the Balmer, that scientist, and further more detailed discovery of spectroscopy, Johannes Rydberg, a Swedish spectroscopic. So that is their Rydberg constant. Now students, we study Bohr model of hydrogen atom. Niels Bohr, a Danish physicist, in 1913 explained the hydrogen atom spectrum in detail. So students, at first we make the lowest possible state. This one lowest possible state, that is denoted by N1. Then this N2. This one N3. Then N4. Then N5. And we can write here this N infinity. And 6, many layers. So when the hydrogen atoms energy supplied, so the electron, we know students, only hydrogen have a single electron. That electron exists in higher cell. If that electron come from higher to ground cell, suppose first, then this way, if this electron come on this ground level from higher cell, so these lines are a scientist observed by Lyman. So though known as Lyman series. And this spectrum observed in ultraviolet region. This we can observe only ultraviolet region. Why? Because there is more energy released out, and ultraviolet region have more energy. Other scientists already, Balmer explained the hydrogen spectrum in 1885. When electron come only second cell, higher to second cell that time, on this cell, then that series are Balmer series. This one is Balmer series. L is silent in this. This Balmer series observed in visible region. That we can observe different color. So students, these lines we can see colored. These lines are colored lines because they observe in visible region. So they are colored line. And if the electron come from higher to third cell, only this third cell, this one. So these series name, this series known as Paschen series. Paschen series. So students, we have to remember their name. If electron jump from higher to first cell, that is Lyman series. First to second cell, Balmer series. From higher to third cell, that is Paschen series. And this observed in infrared because they have lower energy. We know infrared lower than visible than ultraviolet. Further, if electron jump from fourth cell higher to infinity to fourth, that series are bracket series. Bracket series. So they also observed in infrared IR because they have lower energy. And if electron jump prior to fifth cell, IR to fifth cell, that series known as Fund series. Again, P is silent, Fund series. So they also observed in infrared. So five series observed in hydrogen spectrum. First one Lyman, then Balmer, Paschen, Brackett and Fund series. So these three series, Paschen, Brackett and Fund observed in infrared. This Balmer only visible and this one ultraviolet region. So we can observe the color in only Balmer region. So students, before explain this spectrum, the Bohr model gives some hypothesis, assumption about the atom. He assumed that atom have some energy level, quantized energy level. That energy level are stationary orbit. Because in atom center have, there are some concentric like this. Circular path and these are orbits given by Niels Bohr. These name is given by orbit, a fixed path. So this lowest possible orbit name is N1, then N2, N3, N4, N5 in this way. Lowest possible. According to Bohr, their name is given K, L, M, N, O, P, like this. O, P, Q, in similar way, alphabets, 4, 1, 2, 3. This one is lowest possible. After that, we can say this one is ground state. He assumed, Niels Bohr assumed some that are circular path orbit objects, the concentrically they are arranged according to nucleus and their name is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or K, L, M and O, P. And when electron remaining any orbit, neither energy released nor absorbed. He assumed this, when electron remaining on any orbit, neither energy released nor absorbed. He assumed this. And this lowest possible energy of this cell, when distance increase, energy increase. And radius increase, when distance increase, radius also increase. He gave the formula to find out of any cell, any energy, and wave number also find out. So these are some postulates. First, in atom have some fixed level that are energy level, stationary or orbit, three name. The given their name is energy level. Energy level. These level are stationary state. Stationary means they have a fixed place, fixed path, they can find out a fixed place. When electron remaining any orbit and any energy level, neither energy release nor absorb, we assume this. Further, when electron jump lower to higher, when come from lower to higher, from a electron this place, move to this and this place, so it have to absorb energy from surrounding. For example, if a student is studying in first class, if he want to in second class, he give the exam of third class to have to study. Means learn from something from surrounding, from their father, mother and co-workers, peer group, teachers. So in similar way, if electron jump lower to this, time have the absorb energy. If you want to jump from the ground level to on a table or a upper level, then we have to absorb energy. But if a student come on the top surface, if a person remaining on this fourth place and want to in this place, then what happen? Easily can come. When come from higher to lower cell, that time release energy. For example, if I drop this chalk piece on this place, then it's lower down, it's remaining on the ground, that is lowest possible. So it's release energy. A person come from higher to second level, ground level, then energy release in surrounding. So in this way, we can identify when the electron jump lower to higher, that time spectrum is absorption spectrum. And when electron from higher to lower, that time spectrum is emission spectrum. Other students, which orbits are possible only? According to Bohr, give some, there is a angular momentum. You know angular momentum? Angular momentum is equal to, at first we know linear momentum. Linear momentum we know, P is equal to mv. Mass into velocity, this one is a linear momentum. Angular momentum, how can we write? For angular momentum we required, in place of mass, we like mass of inertia into angular velocity. Mass of inertia into angular velocity. So, how can we find out? Mass of inertia we know, mr square. Mass of inertia denoted by I, mr square inertia. And angular momentum denoted by omega. Mass of inertia denoted by I. That is, omega is equal to linear velocity by r. Students, these are the formula. Inertia is equal to mr square, omega is equal to v by r, linear velocity by r. So what is angular momentum? Angular momentum is equal to mass of inertia is mr square. Mass which? Mass of the electron. What are the mass? Mass of the electron into angular velocity v by r. So when we solve, then r cancel to square. So we can say angular momentum is equal to mvr, mass of the electron. So students, he find out this angular momentum means he could not find that is this is fix. How can fix? Only in atom found some certain fixed stationary orbit or energy level, their angular momentum mvr, angular momentum mvr is equal to nh by 2 pi. This is the formula given by Niels Bohr. Angular momentum is equal to nh by 2 pi. What is the n? N is a number of natural number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if this is not equal, the electron does not exist. So this is the main characteristics given by Niels Bohr. Electron only possible energy state or level, their angular momentum is equal to nh by 2 pi. What is h? H is Planck's constant, already given by a Max Planck in 1900. And so now further we study more energy of electron and radius of the electron. Next postulates of Bohr model is we find out energy of the electron remaining in that orbit. So this was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cells. The orbit 1, the n1, n2, n3, n4, n5. So these are the energy electron. How can we find out? He gave a formula that energy of any that orbit is equal to minus 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 z square by n square joule per atom. Students, this one is a formula given by Niels Bohr for hydrogen and hydrogen like species. In hydrogen, this z is equal to 1. So this formula is equal to माइनस 2.18 इंटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 18 वन बाई एन स्क्वायर जूल पर एटम. सो दिस वे ही कैन फाइंड आउट एनी सेल एनर्जी. सो व्हाट व्हाई दिस इज अ नेगेटिव साइन. नेगेटिव साइन व्हाट इंडिकेट्स स्टूडेंट्स, व्हेन दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन, बिकॉज दिस इज हाइड्रोजन एटम, हाइड्रोजन ओनली वन प्रोटॉन एंड वन इलेक्ट्रॉन, that electron remaining on this lowest possible place. But when electron remaining free away from the nucleus, means at infinity, when this n value infinity, then this energy zero. So when electron away from the atom, means from the nucleus, there is no relation, no attraction, that time energy is zero. It is assumed zero. But when it attract towards nucleus, so their energy is lowest possible energy. When n is equal to 1, so this is lowest possible energy for hydrogen. After that, the electron is not come into nucleus, this is lowest possible. For other atom, this z value increase, this lowest value further, negative value increase. So students, these are the value easily can identify. What is this? This 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18, easily remember, because 2.18 and power also similar. So this one also a Rydberg constant. Rydberg, a scientist, already we discussed in the, that is wave number, this also a Rydberg constant. If a electron jump from higher to other cell, suppose that is first cell E1 and other one E2, then how can we find out? So difference of the energy, how can we find out? Suppose it's E1 first cell, E2 second cell, electron jump to this cell, how can find out? Then delta E, delta we can find out, final minus initial, EF minus EI. So this is the formula. So difference of energy find out, final cell energy minus initial cell energy we can find out. So we can apply this formula in this. So you students, you can write delta E means difference of energy is equal to EF. So you can write here minus 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18. Or you can write in place of this value, you can write a constant RH. RH means Rydberg constant. So we can write in this equation, energy of any cell is equal to, that is minus RH Z square divided by N square joule per atom, joule per atom. So in this way, you can write this value minus RH and Z value, Z is equal to hydrogen 1, so we ignore 1 by NF square, if the EF means final cell. And if you write EI means initial cell, then you write minus RH 1 by n I square. So how can you identify the difference? Then delta E is equal to difference of energy, final minus initial, means minus R H 1 by n F square, and again minus, and again this minus R H 1 by n I square. So in this way, this minus minus symbol plus. So students, minus RH 1 by n F square, then this value plus RH Rydberg constant 1 by n I square. So now we can take a common RH, we take Rydberg constant in this common. And initial, you know, first my negative is not, we make good. Then Rydberg constant you write outside. and then 1 by n I initial square minus 1 by final square. This value of the difference of energy. By this we solve the numerical. Then you write the value. This value 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18 1 by n I square minus 1 by n F square. If initial and final value comes negative, then energy release out, that is emission spectrum. If this value positive, then that is absorption spectrum. This is the main difference. How can you identify emission and absorption? If this value negative, then energy release in surrounding, that is emission. If this positive, then absorb energy in, and that spectrum is absorption spectrum. By this formula, we can find out the energy difference of when electron jump lower shell to higher shell that time. So this is absorption spectrum. When come higher to that lower shell, that time spectrum is others you can write. So that one is emission spectrum, when from come higher to lower shell. So in this way we can find the value. That are the reason enthalpy energy of the reaction easily can identify. So we can conclude, we write the formula of energy. Delta E is equal to 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18, that is Rydberg constant, 1 by n I square minus 1 by n F square joule. This is the value, and by this formula now we find out the frequency. Next, Niels Bohr find out radius of the atom. Radius he give, radius of any n orbit is equal to 52.9 n square by z, that is picometer. Students, this one is a formula given. What is the n? N is the number of the cell. Z is atomic number. For hydrogen, Z is equal to 1. So this formula is radius of any nth orbit is 52.9 n square picometer. But sometimes this formula given in nanometer also. We know 1 picometer is equal to 1 into 10 to the power minus 12 meter. But sometimes this value given in nanometer, then how can we write this formula? 0.0529 n square nanometer. Students, nano means 10 to the power minus 9, and this picometer, sometimes angstrom also given. In angstrom this formula is 0.529 n square angstrom. So these different formula given nowadays be used in picometer or nanometer. We can find out any cell. When n increase, radius increase. But when atomic number increase, then radius decrease. Why? Because nucleus protons are increased, so the electrons are nearer to the nucleus. So helium radius is smaller than helium plus, lithium plus 2, beryllium plus 3, means all are like hydrogen, but their atomic number 2, 3, 4, so their radius is smaller. So sometimes this question comes in exam, ki helium, lithium, beryllium and hydrogen, which have first radius is smaller. So more the atomic number, lower the radius, because more attraction of the nucleus and the electron come nearer to the nucleus. So this radius we can identify. Another formula given to identify the frequency. Frequency, how can we identify? We know that is energy is equal to h nu. This one formula already know. and the we know difference of energy also we know delta E. Delta V, how can find out? Energy of final cell minus energy of initial cell. So that we already discussed. So this delta E in energy given that one, and frequency how can we write? Frequency value we can write this formula. So frequency is equal to E means delta E by H. By this equation we can find out frequency delta E by H, and delta E value already know. Delta E we discussed that one, difference 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18. Minus 18, that is Rydberg constant, and value 1 by N I initial square minus 1 by N final square of the orbit divided by H. As students, you know Max Planck's constant 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second, and this value in joule. So what happened? Joule cancel and we get the answer in second inverse. The students, when we solve this value, then we get 3.29, that is given in your book, that is 3.29 into 10 to the power 15, because 35 minus 18, that value positive, and 1 by N I square minus 1 by N F square, second inverse or hertz. So in this way we can find out frequency by Bohr model of any element. So students, this data we can easily identify. Another formula given by Balmer, that is wave number. Students, wave number how can we identify? This wave number is equal to reciprocal of wavelength, we know that is formula. And wavelength how can we identify? That is by the equation C is equal to nu lambda. So lambda how can we identify? C by frequency. So wave number nu bar is equal to 1 by C by nu. So in this way it comes frequency by speed of light. And frequency, students, we already find out. So that is wave number is equal to 3.29 into 10 to the power 15 and 1 by N I square minus 1 by N F square divided by C. Speed of light, speed of light in vacuum is, you know, 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second, and this already second inverse. So in this way we can find out second inverse cancel, we find meter inverse. We can find this value by solving this, then we number is equal to this again a new Rydberg constant, that is we already discussed 1.09677 into 10 to the power 7. When we solve 8 minus 15, then 7, 1 by N I square minus 1 by N F square, and that value ans unit is meter inverse, because meter goes to this. Earlier this Rydberg constant we study in Balmer, this formula we identify this way, वेव नंबर इज इक्वल टू 1,09,677 दैट वैल्यू इन सेंटीमीटर इनवर्स. स्टूडेंट दिस वैल्यू इन मीटर इनवर्स. सो इट्स मल्टीप्लाई बाय इट्स मीटर इनवर्स एंड सेंटीमीटर इनवर्स. सो डिवाइडेड बाय 100 बिकॉज सेंटीमीटर इज स्मॉलर वैल्यू. सो 1/ni इनिशियल स्क्वायर माइनस 1/nf फाइनल स्क्वायर दैट इज सेंटीमीटर इनवर्स. नॉर्मली जो न्यूमेरिकल भी यूज सेंटीमीटर इनवर्स स्मॉलर वैल्यू बट अकॉर्डिंग टू बामर दिस वैल्यू इज 2 स्क्वायर एंड दिस मोर देन 2. सो स्टूडेंट्स डोंट कन्फ्यूज इन डिफरेंट फॉर्मूला. यू रिमेंबर ओनली वन फॉर्मूला द डिफरेंस ऑफ एनर्जी दैट इज गिवन बाय दिस 2.18 into 10 to the power minus 18. Easily remember 18 and this 0.28 and this value final initial minus final. This one is and in all have initial minus final. If this value negative that time emission spectrum, if this positive then absorption spectrum. By this we can identify. Niels Bohr further find out velocity of the electron also. This velocity find out is slightly difficult, complex, but it is directly proportional to atomic number. When atomic number increase, velocity of the electron increase, and it is inversely proportional to quantum number, principal quantum number. Means when principal quantum number value increase, this velocity decrease. It means lower principal quantum number value. This also comes many times. What are the velocity of the electron? Directly proportional to atomic number, inversely proportional to its quantum number, principal quantum number. Principal quantum number we will study after that, because the Bohr given that value 1, 2, 3. That 1, 2, 3, 4, these are value principal quantum numbers. Or we can write K, L, M and OP. These values are principal quantum number. So in this way, Bohr successfully explained all the spectrum, absorption and emission. He easily identify what are the energy of the cell, what is the wavelength and frequency, and absorption and emission occurs. But he could not explain helium atom. But he explained only hydrogen. Hydrogen and hydrogen-like species means single electron system like hydrogen, helium plus 1, lithium plus 2, beryllium plus 3. He explained only such type of species means single electron species. He could not explain multi-electron system. So students, now we observe what are the limitation or drawback of Niels Bohr. Students, drawback and limitation of Niels Bohr model. Although he successfully explained hydrogen and hydrogen-like species, means single electron system, hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, means all these have only single electron. He successfully explained. But he could not explain multi-electron system. Multi-electron system he could not explain. Although helium he could not explain. This is the main drawbacks. And the hydrogen spectrum, actually these are not a single line. These lines found a double-double line, means duplet. Duplet he could not explain in hydrogen atom also. Although successfully explained, but sometimes this hydrogen, if a molecule, large number of atom, then this found like this line, duplet, double-double line. He could not explain these lines. Other one, other drawbacks is, he could not explain if this hydrogen spectrum, if we put placed in magnetic field, if you placed any magnetic field in the near, then what happened? This line are further split up into several lines like this. such type lines are separate further if you place this one line in magnetic field. That effect known as Zeeman effect. Zeeman effect, a scientist observed this when hydrogen spectrum, the single line further split up into several lines. So that could not explain by the Bohr model. Other one, if you place this electric field, then these further line again split up into a further several lines. So that effect known as Stark effect. So students, Niels Bohr could not explain Zeeman effect and Stark effect. Sometimes we forgot which field in which effect. So easily remember, that is magnetic field M, and Zeeman's also M name. So you correlate that name means Zeeman means magnetic field. If other remaining, that is Stark effect. Means the hydrogen, the lines, spectrum line further split up in magnetic and electric field. These could not explain by Niels Bohr. Other Van der Beek, why the molecules are formed? Means why atoms are combined and form molecule. Molecule formation, he could not explain molecule, how can formation of a molecule. So these are the limitations. Although he successfully explained hydrogen atom, and after that a new model we will study, quantum mechanical model. Before quantum mechanical model, we will explain some equations like de Broglie equation, Heisenberg uncertainty principle, and dual nature of matter. The students, go through these the formulas in detail given a Bohr model in your reference book, NCERT book, thoroughly study 2-3 times, then you can understand. And there are 2-3 numericals given in your NCERT book at page number 45. You solve that numerical, and this numerical comes at the problem 2.10 and problem 2.11 in our CBSE exam, annual exam, and half yearly exam also. So solve that numerical. This numerical depend on energy and wave number. We already discussed that formula. Only direct formula based question, if that value, you can find out emission and absorption spectrum on that value. And if you have any problem, then write in comment box, like and subscribe. Tomorrow we will study quantum mechanical model. Thank you. Have a nice day.